Now, in this video, our topic is acceptance, refusal, and hesitation. I'm going to answer 5 questions. Question number 1, how to say yes, please, no thanks, and I'm okay to a Chinese friend who is asking if you would like a cup of tea in his apartment. Number 2, okay, 好的 versus 好啊 versus 好吧. So you're going to hear 3 different okay in Chinese. They are 好的, 好啊, and 好吧. What's the difference between them? Number 3, how to say please go away politely, like to a shopkeeper who is staring at you when you're doing window shopping, or to a waiter or waitress who is staring at you when you are like ordering food, like reading the menu. Number 4, useful expressions. I agree. You're right. Let me think. Let me consider it. Maybe. Maybe not. So I'm going to teach you these useful expressions. Number 5, refusal in the Chinese way. 下次吧 and 再说吧. Those 2 expressions are typical refusal in the Chinese way. I'm going to talk about it later. Okay, let's get started. So, question number 1. How to say yes, please, no thanks, and I'm okay. So the given context is you are in a Chinese friend's house. He's asking you this question. He or she is asking you this question. 喝茶吗? 喝茶吗? So that is drink tea or not. So that would be like, would you like a cup of tea? So what you can answer? Answer 1 can be this one. So that would be 好的,谢谢. Which means, yes, please. 好的, literally, is okay. 谢谢, is thank you. So that would be like, okay, thank you. That is, yes, please. 好的,谢谢. Answer 2 would be, 不要,谢谢. So that is, no thanks. 不要,谢谢. Actually, this is not a good answer. I don't recommend you to answer that to a friend. You can answer that to a salesperson in the street, but not this one. To a friend. So the 3rd answer would be better. So the 3rd answer would be 现在不要,谢谢. 现在不要,谢谢. 现在 is now. 不要 is don't want. 谢谢 is thank you. So now I don't want it, thank you. Now I don't want it, maybe you want it later. So this is a better answer. So it's like I'm okay in English. And then okay. So you say something like 走吧, or like 我们走吧. So let's go. So you're going to hear different answers from your Chinese friend. Answer 1 from your Chinese friend may be 好的, 好的. So that is okay. That okay is neutral. So you can see I make a 的 in brackets. So you can also hear 好, just a simple 好. So 好的, 好, they are the same. They are neutral. So sort of you're asking like to go to class, like shall we go to class? Shall we go to work? So the answer 好的 is neutral. And then this one, 好啊, 好啊. So that is a happy okay. So if you ask your friend to see a movie, maybe you hear the answer, 好啊, 好啊. And then answer 3 is 好吧, 好吧. You can see my face. So that's a reluctant okay. So maybe it's late into the night, you're asking your Chinese friend to go home, like his answer may be 好吧. 好吧, so that's a reluctant okay. And then number 3, how to say please go away politely. So the given context is you're in a shop. You're trying to find something you like or like doing window shopping. So there is a shopkeeper following you and staring at you all the time. You want to say, please go away. What can you say is this one. 我看看, 我看看. Literally, it means I have a look. So actually, it is, I just have a look. So I just have a look. I may not buy anything. So I may not be your potential customer. So please go away. So they understand it. They're going to go away. And then the 2nd case would be, you're in a restaurant. You're reading the menu, but the waiter or waitress is staring at you. You feel uncomfortable. What can you say? You can say this thing. This one. That would be, 我先看看, 过一会儿点菜. 我先看看, 过一会点菜. So if you prefer the Beijing accent, you can use R or you just leave it out. So that would be 我 is I, 先 is first, 看看 is have a look, 过 is pass. 一会 or 一会儿一会 is a while, pass a while. 点菜 is order food. So it means I need time to read the menu. So please go away, leave me alone, like that. So when you say that, the waiter or waitress will leave. You're going to have your private time and space. So it's a bit long. Let's do it again. So
我先看看过一会点菜。我先看看过一会点菜。
Okay, useful expressions. The first one we do is, I agree. So in Chinese, I agree is,
我同意。
我同意。I agree. Number two is, you're right. So that will be,
你是对的。你是对的。
So for this 对, you may find the pronunciation not easy. It's not your problem.Because it's not a full spelling. The full spelling should be D-U-E-I. But it's still not easy for you. So we can do D-W-E-I.
对.
So right now, it's easy for you. You try it.
对. 对. So 你是对的。你是对的。
You're right. So you may say, why don't we use 很? So actually, it's a bit different. So 很 actually is a link word for description adjectives.But when you have a yes or no adjectives, like 对, you are going to use 是的 pattern for you're right. Right now, I just let you know the answer. Later, I'm going to talk about that. So, you're right. What we say is
你是对的。你是对的。
And then number three. So, let me think. So, what we say is
让我想想。
让我想想。So, for this 让, it's always difficult for you to say. What can we do? For this 日, you can make Asia.So you keep this S, so Z. And then on, you can make the English name Sean, but cross out the S. So Z. And then on, try them together. So that will be Asia, Z, Sean, Jean. So 让, 让, fourth thought.
让我想想, 让我想想.
Literally, let me think. If you find it difficult, you can also omit it. You just say
我想想, 我想想。
So that is let me think. And then this one, let me consider it. So in Chinese is
我考虑一下。我考虑一下。
So 我 is I. 考虑 is consider.
一下 is for a moment.
So that is let me consider it. So for this 虑, you may find it difficult. So for this 虞, you have to do is, like you keep your tongue position like the pronunciation E, and then roll your lips like you are kissing. So you have
虞,
so 虑。
考虑
考虑 is consider
一下
So this is 下 You can make S-H-E-E-A-H Try it
下
下 So that will be
我考虑一下我考虑一下
And then maybe What we say is
可能
可能 So it's possible And then this one Maybe not So what we say is Not certain in Chinese So that will be
不一定不一定
maybe not,
不一定。
And then refusal in the Chinese way. refusal is in the Chinese way. Yeah, actually, you can barely hear Chinese say no, but we have our own ways to say no. So let's see. So the situation one is you say this thing. So like,
我们晚上一起吃饭吧。我们晚上一起吃饭吧。
So you're inviting your Chinese friend to have dinner together.So what you say is, we, in the evening, together, have a meal, shall we? Like, bah, I suggest.
So, 我们晚上一起吃饭吧。
So, what about your Chinese friend? He or she doesn't want to go and have dinner together with you. They won't say no. You are going to hear an answer like this one.
下次吧。下次吧。
So what does that mean?
下次
means next time.Ba is I suggest. So sort of, it is, let's do it next time. Let's do it next time. What does that mean? So we don't do it this time. We do it next time. So that is a no. When would be next time? It may take forever. So I don't know. So this is one refusal in the Chinese way.
下次吧。下次吧。
And then another case is, you ask a...Chinese, you just meet, like, if we can be friends. So that will be,
我们可以做朋友吗?我们可以做朋友吗?
So we can be friends or not. So can we be friends? What about the person, like the girl or the guy, doesn't want to be friends with you? So the answer may be this one.
再说吧。再说吧。
So 再 is again in the future. 说 is say. So you may find the 说 not easy for you to pronounce. What can we do? You make it S-H-W-O.
说
Rewrite the U into W.
说
So 再说吧。So 说 is talk. 吧 is I suggest. So all to piece them together, that will be let's talk about it later. Let's talk about it in the future.So talk about it in the future, what does that mean? I don't want to talk about it now. I don't want to talk about it now means no. I'm sorry to let you know, they say no. But they didn't directly say no. They have their refusal in the Chinese way. So these two expressions are typical refusal in the Chinese way. So you may hear it in China. I hope you could understand it well. So that will be 下次吧 and 再说吧. Those two means no.But we don't do it in a direct way, so we say it in an indirect way. That's all for today. Thank you for watching. 再见.